Morning, good morning, good morning. Wherever you are, I say good morning. How are you doing? How is your family? How is everything? And how are you all coping in this time of COVID-19? Especially in Africa, where there is no help, people have been locked up for this this issue of this virus. Well, I don't have much to say. About that. All I know is that God is in control. God knows how to protect and provide for His own children. That at the end of the day, I know that all of us will come out triumphantly. We come out triumphing over all the evil that the enemy plotted and planned for in this world. Or let me put it like this. Okay, I want to give you one, as I hear from God, I want to give you this revelation that I God gave to me. It's a very deep revelation about what is going on, and all these things is just to make you to have peace in this critical situation that we are facing right now, that we're into. It will help you to have peace. Remember, Jesus said in the world, you have many problems, you have many trouble, but in me you have peace. He said it to us before he left back to heaven. He said, in this world, you have so many problems, so many, but only in the word of God that one find peace. In the word of life, in the word of God that you find peace. Only those that understand the word of God, that knows the word of God, find peace in Jesus. Find peace in the word of God, in the word that created the heavens and the earth. Only those that understand that the word of God created the heavens and the earth, they cling to the word of God and they find peace. They always find peace in God. Nothing shakes them, nothing moves them, nothing terrifies them, nothing eliminate them. They are unshakable because they are founded on the rock. On the rock, and that rock, you know, is Jesus Christ. That rock that they are standing is Jesus Christ. So I don't want to talk much. Let me go straight to the thing that God revealed to me about what is going on in the whole universe. I want to give you the cause of this COVID-19. The deep revelation that will map you about what is going on. Okay, I was in the spirit because I was worried, I was saying, God, what is going on, what's happening, and what is the matter? So God spoke to me. I was in the dream, in the spirit. I fell asleep. So God's spirit opened my eyes, took me to a very big field. And I was walking in that field. And that field was a place in the real life. No, it was that field was in the field of, you know, in the missionary place that my father, that we went for. My father was sent to go and do missionary work. As I told you, my father is a priest. So the field was actually the field where we normally play football. It's a very big field. The church, the field for the church, you know, it's a very big land. That field, I was there in the spirit. God took me. I was walking in the middle of that big field. So behold, I saw a skin of a very mighty snake. The skin, you know, remember that snake normally shed the skin out. So I turned, I said, where is the skin goes like a rainbow. So behold, so God said to me, turn, look. As I turned, behold, the snake is still shedding the skin, was doing so with force. This is how it was doing, wearing this, as he's doing it with all the strength, out of him. Was zooming it, or he just do. I said, what is this? As I was doing it, the skin was wearing that, was shedding the skin, as I was doing it. So behold, A very sharp knife was given to me by heaven. A very sharp knife. The two side of this knife was sharp enough. So it just remained for the skin of the head. It didn't have reached to the neck. It just small for the skin to wear out, for the whole skin to come out. So God's Spirit empowered me. I rushed this neck. From the neck, I cut off the head. Very mighty snake, very mighty. I cut off the head of this snake. So as I cut off the head, so behold, in that dream, my father also appeared. My father said, "How did you manage to kill this snake? How did you know that this snake is here?" I told my father that I was just here. I don't know. I saw the skin. I don't know that the snake is still shedding. It's still in the process. It's still shedding the skin. And it just remained little. Just remain that the hair from the neck to the head. As I told you, the snake was doing so. That's how he's doing. It was shedding with all the strength. Doing so, and the skin was coming out. So just remain just little for the snake to finish shedding this with whole snake. Shedding the whole skin before I cut off the head from the neck. My father shouted. So my father went close to it. And as I cut the head, all the whole body, antenna, satellite, this satellite, all over the body, sit down. Different satellite in the body, different antenna in the body of this neck. My father went, go close, take a stick, something, and took the knife and opened the skin. The skin was too fresh because the old skin had been shed. So my father opened it in that dream and called me and said, "See, behold, eggs was lying down, egg." So God Spirit said to me, "Evil want to rebel, they want to give birth, they want to go to the highest level, but I stopped them." God said to me, This is what I did. I did right now through you. That evil want to rebel to the next level. They want to rebel to the level that if not God has stopped them, it will be dangerous. See, let me tell you something. COVID-19 is not all about 5 gigs. It's not. It's beyond what you can understand. Bible said that warfare is not carnal. For the weapons of our warfare are not carnal. The warfare we are fighting is not something you can see with your physical eyes. If they achieve it in the realm of the spirit, forget about it. But if God stopped them in the realm of the spirit, what is 5 gigs? 5 gigs is not, it's nothing. 5G is nothing. It's not. Evil people in this world, authorities of this world, you can see that they are working together. They will give 14 days, after 14 days, they give another 14 days. They are working together. This one will just give his own. Before you know what's happening, another one will give his own. Because they are working, authorities of this world, they are working together as one. But the church of Jesus Christ, people that are calling themselves the church, they are scattered. They are enemy of themselves. This one will say, the God of Adeboye, the God of Tibidishua, the God of Kumuyi, the God of Oyakilumi. We now understand that there are many gods that this people are serving, not the God of heaven. But the people of this world, they are united. Look at how they will pass order, everybody will pay. So God said to me that the authorities of this world, the evil of this world, they want to rebel. They want to go to the highest level, but I stop them. God said, "I take them from behind. I stop them." This is what I use you to do by cutting off. God said to me, assuming this snake shed this skin and complete it, and nothing happens, that the level the evil will go in the world will be great. But God said, through his power, because he's omnipotent, he's omnipresent, he's omniscience God, he sees what you cannot see. He stopped them. He stopped the evil. He cut off their plan. That's why they are mad. They are totally mad now. And they know that the all-powerful stop them. When a snake will shed the skin out, becomes young, becomes, if the snake becomes more dangerous, becomes more deadly. And the eggs inside, they want to give birth. They want to rebirth. They want to rebirth. They want to climb to another particular level. They want to attend to the highest level. God said to them, where are you going? Where are you guys going? Where are you going? He stopped them. It's the time for you to thank God. It's the time for you to thank God. This is what I do look at what's happening. I said, these people that call themselves pastors in Nigeria, in America, they don't know God. They don't know God. Can any one of them come and tell me or tell the world what is going on? What caused this coronavirus, this COVID-19? None of them can do that. But me, tiny man as you see me, I'm powerful. As small, as tiny as you see me, I am powerful enough. I'm powerful enough of God. None of them can stand on my way. I vomit. They can't stand on my way. They can't stand on my way. They are all agents of darkness. They are trapped in darkness, in the evil that they are doing. They can't see the light. They are in darkness. They can't see. They cannot see. All the church is doing is money. They even love money more than the authority of this world. All that they're after is money. Packing it to their own section. Packing it to their own family. Packing it to their own account. Buying jets. Buying all these things. Where will you take all these things to? Look at just if nothing happened. They close down your shrine. They close down your church. Instead of people to seek God and pray together as one. Believers are supposed to be one in the whole universe. Forget them. If there's no selfish interest, if there's no different native doctor, jujus that they have, competing with power, evil power, if not so, the Church of Jesus Christ, if they truly love, they would have been a model to the whole universe. And they would have been the unity that Christ, Jesus Christ, prayed before he left, say, Father, let them be one as I am one with you. It will have been seen among the Christians, among the believers, but it is not there. That's why evil is busy spreading. But they cannot spread as long as I'm here. They can't spread. They can't do. They can't proceed. They can't proceed. I will stop them. God of heaven will stop them. God of my Father. My Father introduced me to the God of heaven, to the Holy God. My father and my mother give me, they give me and my brothers and sisters, they give us the best by introducing the Holy God, the righteous God, the all-powerful to us. So as long as I'm here on earth, evil cannot proceed. Evil cannot operate. No, they cannot. It's my pride. It's my own Rolls Royce. It's my own private jet at the moment. But the funniest thing that when you hold on to God, material things comes to you. It comes to you in a truthful way, not in a lying way. God will bless you, prosper you, because He's the owner of heaven and earth. Silver and gold belong to Him. Don't think I'm poor. I'm not poor. Don't think I'm poor. Let's say yourself, I'm not poor. I'm the richest man. Do you know why? Because I have the Holy Spirit. I have the Holy Ghost. I have the one that died and defeated death. If you have Him in your life, you will be as bold as a lion. You will not be afraid of anything. You will not be afraid. Those pastors that are afraid, they are afraid because they are not connected to Him. They don't know Him. They are living. They are living in fear more than you. More than you. So this is what I want you to understand. The evil that want to rebel, the authorities of this world, the evil powers of this world, the mythologists, the religious, evil religious leaders, the evil governments, the evil authorities, the kings and queens that is in evil, that's deep in evil. That big python that I said that God caught off in head and spirit, that was rebelled, you know, that it was shedding the skin and the egg was inside, is stands for all the evil authorities, evil powers in the whole universe. But the all-powerful is powerful. Almighty is mighty. So this is what happened. God cut off. God took them from behind. I don't want to speak this language, but to say this man is not a good man. I would not speak one of my language, but I don't want to say it. But the Almighty, he came from behind and cut off their head. That's why I see them in their fear. See them fear have soaked them. Oh, I want to read something for you to understand. Just give me 1 minute, I'll read something for you to understand. I will like to read this thing. This is what God gave to me when I wake up that day. When I wake up, is this week that I had this revelation. I had it this week, and let me show you. Just wait a minute, let me find it now. Because I will not close this video, I will not end this video without reading it for you. I hope I find it now. Let it work. Okay, I have found it. Please, I just decided to make this video because I know many of you is living in fear. Many of you fear because of what is going on. But this way, can take away every fear out of you and bring boldness in you. For some of you, many of you that is spiritually minded, you understand the meaning of the dream I just said. You understand that this is not me, that this is the Almighty, the All-Powerful that said this. So come on, let's hear it in the Word of God. Right now, let me read it for you in Psalm 53, where God gave me when I wake up and I laughed. Psalm 53 from verse 1 says, The empty-headed fool has said in his heart, there is no God. There is no God. Corrupt and evil are they, and doing abominable iniquity. There is none who does good. God looked down from heaven upon the throne of men to see if there were any who sought, inquire after, and desperately require God. Every one of them has turned back, backsliding and falling away. They have altogether become filthy and corrupt. There is none who does good. No, not one. Have those who walk evil, no knowledge, no understanding. They eat up my people as they eat bread. They do not call upon God as your pastors are eating you up. The evil pastors are eating you up. You are hearing here? There they are in terror and dread. Where there was and had been no terror and dread. For God has scattered the bones of him who encamps against you. You have put them to shame because God has rejected them. Oh, that the salvation and deliverance of Israel will come out of Zion when God restores the fortunes of his people. Then will Jacob rejoice and Israel be glad. Hallelujah. This is great. This is wonderful. You understand what I did now? Powerful. Confirmed. God have cut off the head of evil that got against you. The fake pastors can't proceed anymore. This is their end. Evil authorities can't proceed anymore. This is their end. Do you know what God is doing now? Overturn. The poor become rich. The poor I'm talking about is, blessed are the poor in spirit, for they are the kingdom of heaven. Those that wait for God, I hope they say, don't want to go and do money ritual. Yahoo, yahoo. Prostitution, all manner of evil in ritual to make money, lying with the Bible, all this shouting part and offering, and this, as long as you are not partaker of all this evil to make money. Now, God is exalting you now and blessing you now, prosper your life now. You will be rich from now. But those that by cut God's will to become rich, they are going back to zero. You from nobody to somebody, and people that say that somebody to nobody. This is my message to you. God bless you. Have a blessed day and remain blessed. Okay, so I just want you to understand this. It's good for me to let you know what is going on. As I hear from God, I give to you. I promise you that. You know, many, all of you, I promise you, all of you, I promise you, I will never hide anything from you. But sometimes when I'm busy, bear with me. You will always hear from me. We are all one. Spread this video. Share this video. Subscribe to this video for you to always know and understand and be enlightened more. God bless you. Really good.